हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आईटीएलएस एकेडमी। द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर इज हेमाटोपोएटिक स्टेम सेल थेरेपी फॉर ऑटो इम्यून डिजीजेस। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन व्हाट आर ऑटो इम्यून डिजीज, हाउ दे हैपन and what are the symptoms and some important definitions that are related to autoimmune diseases. In this particular video, we are going to discuss some therapies that are derived through the hematopoietic stem cells. So let's start with the hematopoietic stem cell therapy, and these are for autoimmune diseases. Hematopoietic stem cell therapy for autoimmune diseases. The very first point is the current treatments for many autoimmune diseases include the systemic use of anti-inflammatory drugs and potent immunosuppressive and immunomodulatory agents. In recent years, researchers have contemplated the use of stem cells to treat autoimmune disorders. Next point, the immune-mediated injury in autoimmune diseases can be organ specific and non-organ specific. At first, we will see organ specific autoimmune diseases such as type 1 diabetes, which is the consequence of the destruction of the pancreatic beta islet cells, as we know that these pancreatic beta islet cells are responsible for the secretion of an hormone that is known as insulin, and insulin is required for the uptake of glucose in blood vessel cells. Or multiple sclerosis, which results from the breakdown of the myelin covering of nerves. Let us see how this multiple sclerosis occurs. I hope you all are know what is the structure of a neuron. If I draw a diagram that is of the neuron, this is cell body, these are dendrites, this is axon, and these are synaptic lobes. As we know that the axonal part of this neuron is covered with some covering. This covering is present on the both sides of the neuron and this is known as myelin sheath. This myelin sheath is not continuous. This is break. This is absent at some part, and these parts are known as node of Ranvier. Whenever this myelin sheath starts to break off, this breaks off from the surface of the axon or from the axonal membrane. This breaking off, this is known as multiple sclerosis. Next point. In contrast, non-organ specific autoimmune diseases such as lupus are characterized by widespread injury due to immune reactions against many different organs and tissues. One approach is being evaluated in early clinical trials of patients with poorly responsive life-threatening lupus. The objective of hematopoietic stem cell therapy for lupus is to destroy the mature, long-lived and autoreactive immune cells and to generate a new, properly functioning immune system. In most of these trials, the patient's own stem cells have been used in a procedure known as autologous or from one's self hematopoietic stem cell transplantation. Next is, recent reports suggest that this replacement therapy may fundamentally alter the patient's immune system. Richard Burt and his colleagues conducted a long-term follow-up, that is from 1 to 3 years, of 7 lupus patients who underwent this procedure and found that they remained free from active lupus and improved continuously after transplantation without the need for immunosuppressive medications. One of the hallmarks of lupus is that during the natural progression of disease, the normally diverse repertoire of T cells become limited in the number of different antigen they recognize, suggesting that an increasing proportion of the patient's T cells are autoreactive. Here in this diagram, it is shown that how stem cells are collected for the transplantation. You can see here in a first step, there is collection of cells. These collected cells include hematopoietic stem cells, B cells and T cells and many other cells. In the next step, hematopoietic stem cells harvest with or without ex vivo CD34 selection. CD34 is a selection marker that is used for the selection of hematopoietic stem cells. Here in this diagram you can see these are hematopoietic stem cells that are harvested with the help of CD34. These extracted hematopoietic stem cells are sent for the preservation, and the method used for the preservation is cryopreservation, that is preservation at a very low temperature. In the next step, whenever there is a need, these preserved stem cells are taken and implanted in the patient that require the stem cell transplantation therapy. This was all about ex vivo selection. If we talk about the in vivo selection, in vivo host B and T cells depletion. Conditioning regimens are TBI, ATG, cyclophosphamide, fludarabine and other chemotherapies. You can see here most of the cells are depleted or destroyed. Only some of the cells are remaining here for the use in therapy. Development of hematopoietic stem cell lines for transplantation. First point is the ability to generate and propagate unlimited numbers of hematopoietic stem cells outside the body, whether from adult or umbilical cord blood or fetal or other embryonic sources, would have a major impact on the safety, cost and availability of stem cells for transplantation. The current approach of isolating hematopoietic stem cells from a patient's own peripheral blood places the patient at risk for a flare-up of their autoimmune disease. This is a potential consequence of repeated administration of the stem cell growth factors needed to mobilize hematopoietic stem cells from the bone marrow to the bloodstream in numbers sufficient for transplantation. Coming to the next point, whether embryonic stem cells will provide advantages over stem cells derived from cord blood or adult bone marrow hematopoietic stem cells remains to be determined. However, hematopoietic stem cells, whether from umbilical cord blood or bone marrow, have a more limited potential for self-renewal than do pluripotent embryonic stem cells. Although new information will be needed to direct the differentiation of embryonic stem cells into hematopoietic stem cells, hematopoietic cells are present in differentiated cultures from human embryonic stem cells and from human fetal derived embryonic germ stem cells. Potential advantage of using pure populations of donor hematopoietic stem cells achieved through stem cell technologies would be a lower incidence and severity of graft versus host disease, a potentially fatal complication of bone marrow transplantation. Gene therapy and stem cell approaches for the treatment of autoimmune diseases. Gene therapy is the genetic modification of cells to produce a therapeutic effect. In most investigational protocols, DNA containing the therapeutic gene is transferred into cultured cells, and these cells are subsequently administered to the animal or patient. Currently, there is an extensive amount of gene therapy research being conducted in animal models of autoimmune disease. The goal is to modify the aberrant inflammatory immune response that is characteristic of autoimmune diseases. Researchers most often use one of the two general strategies to modulate the immune response. Here, the procedure of collecting and transferring the stem cells to the required patient by the help of a virus is given. Let us see what points are included in it. Very first point, cells are removed from patient. These are cells that are removed from the patient. Next, in the laboratory, a virus that is altered so that it cannot reproduce. You can see here the genetic material of this virus is fragmented. In next step, a gene is inserted into the virus. You can see here this is our gene of interest that we wanted to transfer. This is ligated in virus genetic material. Next, the altered virus is mixed with cells from the patient. Here you can see these are the cells and this is the virus, that is altered virus. Next point, the cells from the patients become genetically altered. You can see here the genetic material, our desired gene product, is transferred in the cell. Next point, the altered cells are injected into the patient. Next, the genetically altered cells produce the desired protein or hormone. You can see here the desired hormone is produced here. This is indicated by the color here. You can see that our desired was this blue color gene and this is producing that blue color gene here. Serious obstacles to the development of effective gene therapies for human remains, however, for most among these are the difficulty of reliably transferring genetic material into adult and slowly dividing cells, including hematopoietic stem cells. End of producing long-lasting expression of the intended proteins at levels that can be tightly controlled in response to disease activity. Ultimately, stem cell gene therapy should allow the development of novel methods for immune modulation in autoimmune diseases. Rheumatoid arthritis is a debilitating autoimmune disease characterized by acute and chronic inflammation in which the immune system primarily attacks the joints of the body. In a recent study, investigators genetically transferred an anti-inflammatory cytokine, that is interleukin-4, into a specialized, highly efficient antigen-presenting cell called dendritic cell, and then injected these interleukin-secreting cells into mice that can be induced to develop a form of arthritis similar to rheumatoid arthritis in humans. Conclusions. Stem cell based therapies offer many exciting possibilities for the development of novel treatments and perhaps even cures for autoimmune diseases. A challenging research effort remains to fully realize this potential and to address the many remaining questions, which include how best to direct the differentiation of specific cell types and determine which particular type of stem cell will be optimum for each therapeutic approach. Next, gene therapy with cytokines or their inhibitors is still in its infancy, but stem cells or their progeny may provide one of the better avenues for future delivery of immune-based therapies. Ultimately, the potential to alleviate these devastating chronic diseases with the use of stem cell-based technologies is enormous. So thank you very much guys for watching this session. Follow ITLS Academy on various social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp and LinkedIn. Subscribe to our channel ITLS Academy and also do not forget to press the bell icon, so that you can get notified whenever there is an upload. You can also get it on Google Play Store. So thank you very much everyone. Thank you very much for connecting with ITLS Academy. For any helpline, for any help or query, you can call us on our helpline number. Thank you very much everyone for watching this session and for connecting with ITLS Academy.